Hello everyone, this is Shokora Zouheikyoku, aka Chocomint, and welcome back to our last play of Teachers with Love and Passion. In the last play too, we have been talking with Mr. Leonard and kind of almost outed ourselves as an anime lover, in which I thought it was fine, but maybe the other teachers might find it weird. And Mr. Leonard has a strange expression on his face, in which is kind of dangerous, very dangerous worthy, because he looks like he's about to off us or something, like that dead eyes. dead eyes, I'm not sure what he feels about anime. So, hopefully he likes it. I mean, I had a feeling he likes it, but there's no confirmation about it right now, so. And we ended up with a cliffhanger with Mr. Mitchell, Edgar, offering to walk us home, in which we will decide whether we would want that or not. I mean, that's a very gentlemanly action, but are we really close enough to walk home together? And I mean, we're not even that interested in Mr. Edgar for this time. Our priorities for this time is Leonard, guys. Focus on that. So, well, let's start. Let's continue this cliffhanger and maybe reject the offer. Maybe in another time, another timeline, another last play. Nonetheless, but that we will walk home together with you, Mr. Edgar. Well, let's continue. Okay, go with him or don't go. Let's not go.
Sorry, but I think it's better to go on my own.
Hey, don't worry. We can do it another time.
Yeah.
Be careful. Have a good night.
Waving him goodbye, I decided to take the bus to get home quicker.
No GB again. Interesting.
Friday night. People are leaving a job with a fulfilling feeling in their hearts. Everyone is going to pubs to enjoy a cold drink with friends, while others are getting ready to crawl under their cozy blankets reading a good story. The same goes for the teachers. On this quiet Friday night, the school is empty. But the clown is still here. Waiting for the printer to let me finish my work, I sigh heavily in a lonely room. I know I could just pretend I don't care about his work and leave it all for the next week. But if I did it, I won't be able to relax on the weekend. I wish I wasn't such a good girl.
I think it's a good thing though. You're very responsible. But then again, you're putting pressure onto yourself. But on the other hand, if you finish this week, then the next week you don't have to worry about it again. So eventually you have to reach that point in your work, you know. It depends on whether you want to procrastinate or not.
But since I am here, let's make it quick. I don't like how quiet it is in this room.
That sounds kind of scary in itself.
It's nice, but scary as hell.
Yeah, there's a some kind of feeling when you're alone in the dark, especially if there is no one around you and this isn't exactly your home but it's your workplace. I don't know, usually no thieves or robbery happened in school, but who knows what happened. And there's like school legends or school rumors of ghost bombing in the night or something of the kind. Not sure if that's true or not, but still pretty spooky in itself.
Supporting myself against the wall, I look at the teacher's lounge, finding myself all alone. It's strange how I still can see ghostly figures walking around the place from flashes on my memory. Maybe I'm getting used to them now.
Huh? Is it like literally or is it just metaphorically? Or I'm just losing my mind. I hope it's just you losing your mind and not real.
I should talk to someone while I wait. Picking up my phone, I decided to text them to help me cope with the solitude.
Okay. Again, there's Ray, but I don't think it's available again. It's tempting me, alright? Edgar, Leonard, Marcus, Lawrence. So, Leonard, the sweetie, I hope you can help. You can help Hannah with this.
What's up, Leonard?
Hi. I was just thinking about texting you. Is the printer working?
No. But I'm trying to make it work.
I thought it would happen. Is Thomas still at the school? You can ask him to help you. It's part of his job.
He left earlier today.
Seriously?
Yeah, I think I'm all alone here. What?
I was thinking about staying overtime today, but I decided to come home. If I knew you'd be alone, I'll have stayed. I'm stupid.
Don't worry, I'm good. I'd like to have you here.
I'm so stupid.
Sorry, the printer is calling me.
Okay, don't overdo. And have a good night.
Nice. Suddenly, a pop-up warning appears on the computer screen, taking my attention away from my phone. I'll take a step closer, noticing it's the same error from 30 minutes ago.
That sucks. That sucks so bad, yeah.
Granted, I reset my request and tried it again. Putting back the urge to punch the machine.
Indeed.
The hell was it? Almost choking on my saliva, I take a step back, staring intensely at the closed door. Something probably fell on the hall. There's nothing to worry about. I'm all alone here, after all. Yeah, all alone. My heart beats slowly as my curious mind begs me to go check the place to ease my task. I take a look at the computer, seeing the message saying it would take another 10 minutes to complete the request. I'll take a peek, just to make sure it's nothing. Holding my body, I walk out of the room. As expected, the halls are deserted, not a single soul to haunt me. Feeling stupid for worrying so much, I take a deep breath. It's not so bad here. It's quite peaceful. They're empty, their space isn't as scary as I imagined it to be. Somehow, it makes me feel small and forgotten, but also filled with a strange peace. The school is adornment without its kids, so I better try my best not to disturb its sleep. Again? My head turns from side to side, looking with widened eyes, searching for any move. I'm sure I heard it again. It was closer, but at the same time, it sounded muffled. As if it's coming from inside something. Maybe it's coming from a classroom. It can be a cat or the wind hitting the windows. I should pick a place to check first.
So we're going to check the end of the hallway?
Right. The end of the hallway looks a little creepy. But if this is the only option, Swallowing my fears dry, I start walking once again. The dining hall looks scarier than any other area in the school at night. I can't deny that it's starting to mess with my head and making me imagine stupid stuff like ghosts or weird animatronics hidden in the shadows.
Why are you thinking of weird animatronics? Is it reference to something? Like a certain horror game with animatronics? I hope not. Then that should be a little scary.
Hello? After a few seconds of embracing myself, I hear nothing but silence answering my call. Easing the tension on my shoulders, I shake my head, looking in the dark. I can't see much aside from the faint light coming from the windows in the corners, but it is enough to make me feel dumb for being scared. Trying to relax, I support myself on the table, taking a deep breath. Oh gosh! Someone forgot a plate on the table. Something I didn't see until it was too late. What a mess. The sound of heavy footsteps echo inside the empty room. Shivers run down my spine as my body freezes in place. Someone is here. Holding my breath, I stay put, trying to blend myself in the shadows. Suddenly, there is silence again, as if the other one is also afraid to be found. In reaction to my fear, I crouch under the table, accidentally hitting the plate on the floor. Shit! It's coming closer. I need to do something.
Attack? Oh wait, let's wait. I mean, you don't know what will happen, and should you be attacking someone like that? And can you even overpower that person in a sense? So let's wait and hope that they don't see us, in a sense. If in the worst scenario that is someone bad or something of that kind, then we attack. There is always another choice to change your tactics in the middle of a fight or of danger.
Hug in my arms, I close my eyes, waiting for whatever is about to happen. The footsteps run, then suddenly stop closer to me. For a moment, I feel that whoever is there is now watching me.
Anna.
Eh?
Oh, okay, another person. We mean another person. This is very awkward again. Hi, guys. Hi, guys. Oh my god, this is kind of embarrassing on both sides.
Marcus, what are you? Wait, it was you?
I was about to ask you the same.
Words die in our mouths as we slowly realize the stupid situation we have put ourselves in. Sorry, I didn't know you were here.
Yeah, I'm sorry too. I got stuck here after giving some extra classes to a few kids. You know, the sports festival is coming, and some of them are still worried about performing.
I see.
I was probably not messed up when I heard a noise. Your noises.
But this is strange. I only came here because I also heard a noise.
Really?
Yeah, I thought there was something here. At the sound cracking too close to us, we hold our breath. For a moment, I swear,
I saw Marcus' soul leave in his body. I know that's supposed to be a creepy situation, but that distraction kind of made me laugh a little. Cute.
Scare.
We hold on to it. Oh god, that's so cute! The image of them holding on to each other is kinda cute.
Scared, we hold on to each other, burning our eyes to every side of the room. With our bodies glued together, Marcus turns his phone's flashlight on, searching around the tables while I look for anything in the dark corners.
Oh my god, his face though! Keep that one. There's a hidden sign. He's tough, but he's scared of spooky things. That's kind of cute. Is it called Gatmo? Or am I using the word wrong?
You heard it too.
Yes, it was close. Heavy breathing and a fast heartbeat are all here. I just can't tell which of us is making these sounds. As I scan over the area, I find two shining dots on the corner. Marcus, there!
I see the hand on her arm, sir. I see the hand. Also, you guys have nice fingers. Wait, what am I talking about? Moving on, next.
With his hand slightly shaking, he turns his phone in the pointed direction.
Okay, I can see the hand on her arm probably now. Nice. And also, is there something kind of sweet about this? I'm not sure if he's just wants someone close to feel less scared, or it's just instinct of wanting to. I don't know. Usually, when people like hold someone close, it's usually scared or they wanted to protect someone instinctively, just to make sure they're fine and right there with them. So I find it's kind of like a protecting gesture, even though he's kind of scared too. So that's really sweet.
The scary monster shows itself in front of us. A cat?
Oh, it's a cat! Yes! Oh! I thought I heard a meow earlier or something. It is a cat. Okay. Very cute. Yes, a very spooky, scary monster with fuzzy hair and a cute face. Okay.
Over the table, a cute cat is walking, minding his business as we watch in disbelief. I can't believe it.
I feel stupid.
I can't hold my laugh when I realize that we look like two crying babies afraid of the dark.
Okay.
I feel Marcus take a deep breath, calling my attention to ourselves. All this time, I was holding his body too close, or he was holding my body to his so close. I tried to push away, but I stopped when I noticed his arm hugging my waist tightly.
Oh, it's the waist or the arm?
This score is driving us insane.
I mean, I have thought that holding the arm is nice, but the waist? Oh my god, the waist! but usually, it's gonna be very awkward and very embarrassing or very weird to have someone holding your waist if you're not close, but I mean, in this situation, they are both scared, so. Oh my.
I'm going to ask Thomas for a recess.
Priorities, CG? I'm gonna zoom in and look at the CG right now.
What's wrong? Oh.
Blushy.
As soon as he's realized how close we are, he lets go of me, taking a few steps away. We can't see each other's face too well, but I can tell that we are both blushing. Ah. So, the mystery is solved.
Yeah. I still need to pick up my stuff.
Right.
Are you, leaving?
No, I have work to do.
Oh, okay.
I better get back to it now.
Then I'll get going.
Me too.
Okay, bye.
Oh gosh. I stay in the same position, listening to Marcus' footsteps running out of the room.
Oh, that's so cute though. That's kinda cute though. Woo! Yeah, the scenery is very cute.
I can feel my heart beating in every corner of my skin like drums at a live concert. I know it's not because I was scared. Then why am I feeling like my whole body is melting and a lovely feeling?
This
can't be love. I turn to look at a cat, finding him sitting on the table, licking his tiny body.
Well, actually, yeah, I don't think it's love, but you can't deny the attraction here. The attraction. I mean, every single teacher in here is very attractive. And also, you just got a scare, so your heartbeat may be a little fast, so.
Be out of trouble, kitty. Or you will end up like me. Feeling my heart beating flustered, I walk back to the lounge.
Okay, there's no chibi anymore. That sucks. I would love to see her cute chibi a little more longer, but it's fine.
Breeze passed by me faster than I could take note of it. The place I was so afraid of at first has become my favorite spot in the city. I found here a room where my heart can rest assured that I'm not alone anymore.
You didn't say anything about the teachers joining it.
I must have forgotten.
Thomas!
And, well, it's also a place where peace was never an option. Today again, we are all together at the teacher's lounge. But this time Thomas and Ray are here too, to discuss the upcoming sports event. Everything was going as smoothly as possible until Thomas announced a small change on it.
What's the problem with the teachers joining it too?
I am the problem, Thomas.
Okay, Mr. Problem.
I don't feel good about it.
Why? I'm not asking you to play a game like a professional, Marcus. This event is supposed to be fun for the kids. No one is going to take it seriously. And you should take your time to enjoy it too.
Thomas' voice sounds gentle. Almost sorry for arguing with Marcus about his decision. Marcus doesn't look angry like he usually does. This time, he only stares at the floor, with eyes filled with concern and guilt. Is there a background or a story behind it? I wait for someone to say something, but for the first time, no one interrupts the conversation. Troubled, I decided to do it myself. And when is this event happening again?
Tomorrow.
What?
What?
Yes, but don't worry. As I said, this is just for fun. You all should come to school with that in mind.
It's kind of hard not to be worried about it, to be honest. Especially when I'm awful at sports. And I don't feel good about joining my students and making them all look like fools.
Now comes the main surprise.
There's more.
Moving to the corner of the room with Ray by his side, Thomas smiles at us. A smile has always been a source of comfort for me since my first day. But right now, it makes me feel the opposite of it.
You are not going to join your students in the games. Instead, you will join teams for your own game against each other.
The whole room gets silent as the two men in front of us laugh, pleased with their plan.
Oh my god. Oh my. Oh dear. I look to the guys on my side, and all I see is despair. Edgar and Marcus aren't blinking. Leonard is rubbing his eyes under his glasses so forcefully that I thought he was crying.
I believe he might want to cry for that, though.
Mr. Hansen seems to be the only one that doesn't look shocked by this announcement. He looks quite tired, as if this is not his first time going through something like this.
I guess he got used to it, that he's got numb to it all. This kind of shenanigans has happened a lot of time before. It will be so fun. Okay, good for you, Soles.
What? No, it won't.
Why?
Because this is not fair. Marcus is the best of sports. He will win anything.
This is not about it, Mitchell. We shouldn't be worried.
Of course we do. What's the point of competing if not for prize?
Have you decided on the teams already?
Yes, I did it last night.
Oh, okay, hold on. If I am on Marcus' team, then just forget what I said.
Oh my god!
Very smart, Edgar, very smart.
Laura, give me patience.
Shut up, Ed. Let Thomas finish it.
Thank you, Christine. You'll be separated into red team and yellow team. The yellow team is formed by Kent, Lawrence, and Miss Fine.
Okay.
What?
And the red team is formed by Mitchell, Blaine, and Christine.
Hell no.
Objection!
What is it now?
Switch me with Hanson, and I'll shut up.
Moving on!
He's ignored it!
Wait a minute.
What?
What about you?
Eh?
Are you going to play against each other too? Or will you just watch while we play forts?
Oh, unfortunately, I won't be able to join the game since I'll be the judge for it tomorrow.
Ray?
Oh, he knew!
What a great excuse!
I'll play the doctor. I mean, he's literally the doctor.
What?
Do you think the kids want to hurt themselves at a sports event?
He is right.
I just hoped a bit, because he won't give me too much trouble.
Don't worry about it. We will make sure not to cross your door.
Good. The tension between them is something impossible to ignore. They are both smiling, but their eyes show a sickening sarcasm. Noticing the uncomfortable silence taking over the room, Thomas clears his throat, calling all the eyes to him.
I think this is all we have to say. I hope to see you all tomorrow at the event.
We don't have a choice anyway.
I can't wait!
Oh my god. Of course you can't wait, you're not participating in the games! You're the judge!
Yeah, it'll be fun.
And you're the doctor, you're not participating in the game either.
Pretending not to see everyone's annoyed expression, Thomas and Ray leave the room laughing excitedly.
Thomas doesn't play fair sometimes.
Lawrence, can't you do anything about it? He is your friend.
Forget it. It will be worse if we try to stop him.
Looking at their tired faces, I can't help but think about the old days when I was still at school. Every event used to be a reason to skip classes and make new memories. But now that I'm on the other side, I understand why my teachers were never really excited about it. We are wasting precious work hours on an event we are too tired to think about. Plus, this is going to be embarrassing.
I got it. We are all annoyed with Thomas, but can you all stop with the long faces? It's a school event! We need to do it for the kids.
Yeah, man.
We must make an unforgettable show tomorrow. This is going to be so good. The kids will talk about it for years.
Are you serious?
Oh, yeah! You guys know that some kids are too shy to join the event. They will probably be hiding, hating every minute of it. If we don't do something, this will turn into an awful memory for them. Let's make them laugh tomorrow.
Oh, that sounds a nice idea, actually.
Edgar may not realize it, but he just said exactly what I needed to hear. He reminded me once again why I am here and why I became a teacher. This is my chance to make a difference, so let's do it.
I hate to admit it, but Ed is right. We need to do our best for them too, like we always do.
No, hear me out, Tim. Marcus may be good, but I'm not letting him win so easily.
Are you serious?
You?
I'm on it.
Okay.
If we are fighting, then I'm not staying on the losing team.
Good. I have my targets on you, Marcus.
Okay. You know what? You guys are right. This may not be so bad. After all, I'll have a chance to throw all the balls I want at you, Mitchell.
Oh my god. Boys.
Oh shit, I forgot about it. What?
The bell rings above our heads, marking the start of our countdown before the competition. Making friends and firing up the competitive spirit in our hearts, we go back to our classes. Nice.
Wait, this is a good pause for our play to today. So, we have quite a spooky night in being alone in the school, but actually we weren't alone at all. There was someone there with us, even though we don't know it. And we got spooked by a cute fuzzy monster that is minding his business inside our school. Just chilling and being cute. A cat. Very nice. But thanks to that, we got a little of heart-bounding interactions with someone, and I find that very cute indeed. And moving on, next we come to the fourth sport festival event where all the teachers are forced into doing it. And after some pep talk and ideas and inspiration from Edgar, have the right mindset, we actually going to do it, and let's make a memory that everyone won't forget. But that will be for another video, as we're gonna leave it at a hip cliffhanger here. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next video of Teachers with Love and Passion. Bye bye!